Believers say there is no scientific proof that God doesn't exist. Atheists say that there is no scientific proof that he does. Believers say that the Bible proves God's existence, whereas atheists say that the Bible is just a bunch of fictional stories. And yet, whilst there is no actual scientific proof that the stories in the Bible are indeed false, archaeologists are constantly finding proof that some are actually true.
Know before you go!
In 1951, archaeologist Dame Kathleen Kenyon was called into the coast of the Dead Sea to give her opinion on a site that possibly could be the famous city of Jericho. Unlike other archaeological dig sites that are located close to water sources that have now either dried up or have become flooded, the underground water supplies of Jericho had continued feeding the city up to this day. The site Kathleen was sent to inspect is known today as Tel Jericho. After some initial digging and evaluation, Kathleen decided that there was simply not enough evidence to either disprove or confirm that this was indeed the fabled walled city of Jericho. So Kathleen called in a team to continue the dig. Kathleen and her team continued to dig for another 6 years, and what they found would change everything. The Jericho city site had initially been dated to around 4000 BC. This surprised most scholars at the time because, according to them, the widespread use of agriculture and the domestication of animals had only occurred around 1,000 years earlier. Kathleen and her team had discovered that the site of Jericho had been built and rebuilt on top of itself over and over, and that the site had been inhabited from as early as 9,400 BC. Kathleen had found that over 10,000 years ago, shortly after the Ice Age had passed, but woolly mammoths still existed, when the majority of mankind was a nomadic race of small clans of hunters and gatherers living off the land and striving for survival, the people of Jericho had formed one of the first mass groupings of different clans to create a bustling city about the size of Washington Square Park, which is the first known settlement to have been surrounded by walls. Inside the walls of Jericho, Kathleen uncovered something even more surprising: a tower nearly 30 foot tall, and that was built around 8000 BC. The majority of Jericho's first people lived in mud houses around 14 foot in diameter. These conical structures resembled mud teepees and had sunken mud plaster floors. Each house also had its own area for storing grain. After an unknown event, Jericho's walls were destroyed and its population was replaced by a different group of people. These people also built their houses from mud, but they used mud bricks. This made their houses and, of course, Jericho's walls stronger and more advanced. These people were also more numerous than their predecessors, growing to a population of approximately 2,000. After around 1,500 years, disaster struck, and for some reason, all signs of life in Jericho and the surrounding areas completely disappear. This event, known as the Great Decline, is thought to have been when the Noah's Ark mass flooding event could have occurred. For around 2,000 years, Jericho then remained uninhabited until the Copper Age, but it wasn't until the early Bronze Age that Jericho built its walls once more. Around 2600 BC, the population of Jericho had reached its highest yet, and just 200 years later, an impressive palace complex was built. Then in 2300 BC, for some reason, whether it was war, disease, famine, or environmental catastrophe, the city of Jericho collapsed once more, and it wouldn't be for another 300 years until the city rose again from its ashes. Between 2000 and 1550 BC, the city of Jericho grew tremendously. Evidence of the possible emergence of nobility and royalty begins to appear, and the walls of Jericho become more advanced with the addition of ditches and rectangular towers along its length. According to the Bible, around 1400 BC, Joshua and his army of Israelites attacked Jericho, walking around its walls once a day until the seventh day, when they circled seven times, blew their trumpets, shouted, and the walls came tumbling down. They then took all the bronze, iron, silver, and gold and burnt the rest. Joshua then exclaimed, "Cursed before the Lord is the one who undertakes to rebuild this city, Jericho." On the dig site, Kathleen found that a dramatic event had indeed caused the walls of Jericho to fall and the city to burn. And Kathleen couldn't find any metallic objects to be able to date the event, but the pottery she did find placed the time of this disaster Gloucester at 1550 BC. However, later discoveries of pottery and Egyptian amulets with inscriptions underneath a 3-foot layer of ash place the dramatic event at almost exactly the same time as the Bible does. After this event, Jericho remained unoccupied for around 500 years. So whether you think that the Bible stories are fact or fiction, biographical or fantasy, thanks to archaeologists and science, we can say they are, at the very least, based on a true story.